a few more issues just recently in the Cavite sortie. What are your thoughts on Governor John Vic Remulla handing out 25,000 pesos in cash, 1,000 peso bills, bilang premio, as he said, no? Cash prizes. But that was before Bongbong Marcos arrived. And, you know, he claims that he hasn't broken any laws simply because his own campaign period starts March 25th.
Yeah, but he has publicly already declared his support for Bongbong Marcos. That was a Marcos rally. He's a Marcos supporter. No, and then especially in light of his accusations, no, or their family's accusations, na bayaran daw ang mga Robredo supporters. And yet, siya pala yung nagbabayad, no, sa mga supporters na yun. I mean, as a politician, of course, now common law rules are very strict, pero talaga mga rallies noon, people expect raffle, pakain, ganyan, pahakot, no? I do support the COMELEC regulation na, you know, because elections are expensive, no? Nabawasan yung mga ganon. And yet, you have here the governor flaunting, using money, no, to get supporters to join the rallies of Bongbong Marcos. So, hindi niya pwedeng takasan yun, eh, because it was a Bongbong Marcos rally, and he's the primero supporter of Bongbong in Cavite. Mm. And he's giving out money, 25,000, to these rallies. Mm.
So when Remulla says there were no national candidates on stage, of course, it's a technicality there. Yeah. But do you believe, Teddy, that's a good enough reason?
No. Kadalasan naman, well, that's their style. Kadalasan naman, it's the politicians that try to bring in the crowd before the main guests arrive. Mm. Unlike sa amin kasi, andyan na yung tao eh, bago dumating yung mga guests. But for them, and I know this because I've seen rallies like this before. No? Ando muna yung mga politicians, yung mga kapitan, yung mga mayor, hinihintay yung primary guests. No? And then, so they try to rouse the crowd. And in the case of Governor Remulla, pera ang ginagamit, paraffol.
What action do you believe the COMELEC should take?
Ayan nga, if they're really very serious, no, because kami, sinusulatan kami. You have to always account for your expenses. Bawal daw magpalugaw, no? Seryoso sila, sinasabi nila. So, how about raffles? Raffles during the rallies. You cannot say it's divorced from the main rally because the crowd is there waiting for the candidate, and raffle is a pre-program activity. It's part of the campaigning, no? Kaya dapat kung seryoso talaga yung COMELEC at paniniwalaan ng lahat ng kampo, dapat singilin nila si Governor Remulla.
Mm. Okay, now let's talk about the debates. It's quite interesting, of course. The camp of Mr. Marcos has said he will not be attending any of the debates. And you have Vice Presidential candidate Walden Bello calling on the COMELEC also to hand out penalties to candidates who don't attend debates.
Agree. Because COMELEC has all of these regulations. It's some of them are impractical, but we are really trying hard to comply with them. Mm. And now you have these debates, which is really very important in molding the decision of people, especially for the president and the vice president. And that you have one candidate who's nabbing a COMELEC sanctioned debate. So hindi ba sampal yun sa COMELEC? So there should be, to have teeth in the regulations, dapat may mga penalties.
Now, discussed in the last debate was the 200 billion peso tax liability of Mr. Marcos, and in Cavite, he also didn't answer reporters when he was asked about that.
Yeah. Kaya nga, sa akin, simple lang eh. If you want to lead the country, pay your obligation. No? Ang sinasabi nila, it's still under litigation. Pero the fact that BIR is trying to collect, dapat nga, mas pinapalakas yung kaso nila because you have this government agency that's that's saying that, well, this is your property, you have to pay your estate taxes, even if it's still under litigation. No? So how can he propose solutions to the economic crisis that we are facing when he himself is not paying taxes? And we need those taxes. No? We need the budget in order to address these issues, this rise of gasoline prices. No? Kasi yun din yung kinakonect ko dun. Eh, no? Tinatanong siya, ano bang solution mo no? dito sa oil price increase? No? Sabi niya, magbigay tayo ng ayuda. Saan kukunin ng gobyerno ng ayuda? Ayaw nga ng government to suspend excise taxes. Eh. Well, you have that that estate taxes na makalaki, which can be used to provide relief to the public, our public transport system right now when we're facing these oil price hikes.
Okay. Now, you have analysts also saying that Lenny's votes are being cannibalized by the alternative candidates, right? So the question is your camp or is the group trying to still dialogue with the other candidates for some of them to withdraw?
I think eventually it's going to happen. Right now, let them exercise their right campaign. In fact, maganda rin yun kasi binabanatan rin naman nila yung ibang kampo. Eh. Not so much Lenny, no? But much of the base, their base actually is with us. But so right now, we have this alliance and we're saying, sige, go ahead. We can use them to hit Marcos when Lenny Robredo wants to focus
but
on her
is
program.
The Lenny camp, is your camp in touch with Senator Manny Pacquiao? Because there were talks of some sectors hoping that Senator Manny Pacquiao would withdraw and he would be able to, of course, support the vice president and also help out in Mindanao.
I'm not privy to any negotiations though with Pacquiao or with Ping or even with Leo Didexman. No? Ako mismo, I'm talking to Leo D on an issue basis. No?
Yeah.
He is endorsing us also on an issue basis. Eventually nga, tulad ng sabi ko, I think when they realize that this is going to be a Lenny versus, let's say, BBM or Marcos, then a lot would probably say, okay, let's go to somebody who we believe in anyway, which is Lenny Robredo, who espouses the same programs and platform that we fight for. So I think mangyayari naman yun eventually. But for the moment, still halfway in the campaign, so I think I don't foresee Manny Pacquiao or any of the presidential candidates withdrawing at this time. But I'm pretty sure when election day nears, their support base, maybe not the candidates themselves, pero yung support base nila ay lilipat at tutulong kay Lenny Robredo.
Teddy, you have questions here from viewers, actually. Wondering, since you've been red-tagged yourself, are you doing anything differently with your security? And what action do you plan to take?
No. Wala akong kasamang police. I've been like that since I was mayor. Been going around Ifugao. Wala akong really mga bodyguards. Actually, when I go in the campaign trail in Ifugao, in previous elections, I get to meet the NPA rebels there. And we talk. You know? Some of them are Ifugaos themselves. No? So ngayon, even with the red tagging, not really very worried about my security. I belong to two worlds. Eh? I'm an activist, and at the same time, my family, Browners, are also military. So, so very confident when it comes to my security. Wala naman akong kabanit.
Okay. Now, there are, of course, complaints against Undersecretary Badoy, but your camp itself, are you planning to take action against her?
Ako, no. No. Temporary lang naman si Badoy hanggang May 9 lang naman siya. After that, mawawala na yung kanyang power.
All right. Let's talk about, speaking of Badoy, the NTFL-CAC. If you win as senator, will you keep funding the NTFL-CAC?
This is my personal position. Ako I'll move for dismantling. Plain and simple, that's my position. Buwagin yung NTFL ka.
Oo. But what about projects that are meant to go directly to communities that were once infiltrated by the NPA? That was the whole point of the NTFL CAC. It had funding, so then it could start... Go ahead.
Yeah, but what's the use of government agencies like the Department of Agriculture, DSWD? Then the whole point nga of our program is let's focus on developing the countryside, the impoverished places, ancestral domains. Kasi nga, statistics would show that marami sa mga pumapasok sa rebelda, sabi daw nila, are katutubo. No? Because of what they're experiencing within their ancestral domains. So, yun yung ating tugunan. We may still have the same budget, not under NTFL-CAC, but let's give it to the Department of Agriculture, the National Commission for Indigenous Peoples, DepEd, bigyan ng edukasyon, no? Yung mga vulnerable groups to extremism and extremism and people or vulnerable groups who might join the insurgency. So akin, yun yung aking position. Not have an agency with all these powers and using the money to as conditions, no, for LGUs to harass and threaten yung mga farmers, yung mga estudyante, even yung katutubo.
Oo. Okay, so you will abolish the NTFL-CAC if it were you. What about the rice tarification law?
Sa akin, importation...
Considering galing kayong Nueva Ecija, right?
Yeah. We've talked to farmers, to even yung mga agricultural officials na mga LGUs na pinuntahan namin, they're very much against rice tarification. No? Sa akin, as a policy, ang rice tarification or importation for that matter should just be a temporary solution. Kasi talaga naman sometimes when there is a food shortage, grabe yung bagyo, o kaya yung tagtuyot, then you need importation. But ang problem, it has become the policy of government. So sa akin, review it or even possibly repeal it. Kasi ang nangyayari na ngayon is pag may problema sa agrikultura, then okay, meron naman dyang importation. That's why sa akin, maybe... focus really on helping the farmers. Kasi lagi nang sinasabi, mas mura kasi pagkain from Thailand, from Vietnam. But the reason why it's cheaper there is because the farmers are also subsidized in this country. So before we open up the Philippines to food importation, let's first empower our local producers, no? Para kaya naman nila mag-compete sa vegetables, sa food galing from our neighbors. Sa akin,
okay.
Repeal it.
All right. Now, very quickly, what would you say is this administration's biggest failure?
The lack of coherent leadership. That to me, because it encompasses everything, whether it's responding to the crisis, you know, the health pandemic, as well as the economic crisis we're facing, or even defense of our territory of the West Philippine Sea. Yun lang. Walang clear leadership ang pinapakita nitong administration. Mm-mm.
But what would you consider its achievement?
That's a very difficult question to answer, Karen. But maybe siguro the political will, because ako, naging congressman ako there were laws that were passed, whether it's the National Mental Health Law or the new law on HIV/AIDS.
What about BARM? What about BARM?
Yeah, the BARM, which I supported both in the Aquino and in this administration. Pagdating doon sa mga legislative initiatives that I have personally also pushed in Congress, and ironically, it passed during this administration. They will, no, talaga, pag sinabi nila na gusto natin ito, then it really passes through the legislative process.
Oo. Now, what do you consider your biggest achievement?
Me? Ako? I've been in public service for almost 30 years. And I think, personally for me, biggest accomplishment ako is being able to fight the temptation of corruption. Your former mayor, governor, congressman, almost 30 years, talagang grabe araw-araw you face instances of, you know, enriching yourself. So I think that to me personally is my biggest accomplishment. Aside from the programs that I've instituted in Ipugao, as well as the laws that I've pushed in Congress for 9 years.
Okay. Now, in office, you were not successful in pushing for an autonomous Cordillera region.
Yeah. It's a question that I cannot answer. I think it has to be the Cordillerans themselves, because this has been presented before the Cordillera people twice. It was rejected overwhelmingly. So sa akin, the third time, if you, ako pa rin, iahain pa rin yan, but if it fails, then maybe we want something else, no? Pero ako, I still cling to the dream of having an autonomous region. That's something that we, Makling Dulag, died for during the martial law years, and I still cling to that that dream, that vision.
Okay, now the latest SWS survey, which was conducted February 25 to 28, you are at number 35 to 39. That's, I'm sure you've seen this survey.
Actually, no. I don't look at surveys these days.
You don't look at surveys, so I'm sorry to be the one to tell you. But let me read it for you. So this is an SWS survey conducted February 25 to 28, where you are number 35 to 39, and you have old names in the survey in the top 12. But here's something interesting I want you to react on. So you have Mr. Rafi Tulfo at number 1 and Mr. Robin Padilla at number 2. Then you have two of the Estradas in the top 12 in this particular survey. There's just really one opposition candidate in this survey.
Yeah, if we are to believe the survey, if it's going to be the trend until May 9, then you'll have a Senate wherein I think 1/3 ay either mag-ina, mag-ama, magkapatid, no? And then a lot of celebrities. So you'll have political dynasties, big business, and celebrities in the Senate. And yun siguro yung kinakailangan i-disseminate pa natin sa voters. Is this the type of Senate that you want who represents you? Because you vote for your congressman to represent you. You vote for the senators to be your voice in the Senate. And yet, if you look at it, what interests are they fighting for? Big business, showbiz, political dynasties. Essentially, that's the makeup of Senate right now. Eh. Kaya sa akin, hopefully, what we're doing right now, Head Start is helping me. Also going around, sipag lang talaga. Hopefully that numbers would improve for me. But yun nga, sa akin pa rin, at the end of the day, I still think that there is a mathematical chance that I can make it.
Really? Okay, Teddy, can we talk about these mathematical chances? What makes you say that you can make it to the top 12? Because even here, you have, I mean, Richard Gordon, based on this particular survey, at number 15 to 16. And he's an incumbent senator. So why do you think, Teddy, you can make it?
Well, again, sa akin, still May 9. That's the final survey, no? One is the Lenny base, and it's increasing every time you go around. No? So many people, 50,000 kagabi, 50,000, and never see an opportunity for me to explain myself to 50,000 people. And then word of mouth na lang yan. Oh, ano pa si Teddy, nakabahag. So that's something that they don't forget. No? So aside from the Lenny base, then there's my own bailiwick, which is Northern Luzon. Bihira ang may kandidato ng Northern Luzon. I think there are only a few of them right now. And I speak Ilocano fluently. So I'll appeal to Regions 1, 2, and Cordillera, as well as provinces which have a big Ilocano base. And then the indigenous peoples.
Yeah.
Now, of course, that's the challenge.
Do you spend for advertising, Teddy? Have you spent for advertising, or you're doing it, you're campaigning in a different way? Magkano na ba nagastos ni Teddy Bagilat?
Right now, siguro wala pang 10 million. To be honest, really. We're really mostly focusing on social media, boosting our ads, ganyan. Hopefully, we could have at least a TV ad. Sabi nila kahit isa lang eh. But I'm really targeting indigenous peoples. No? Whether I win or not, no, sa akin kasi the IP vote should also come out. That's also been my challenge. Eh. We're supposed to be 10% of the population, sabi nila. From Luzon to Mindanao, you have 110 ethno-linguistic tribes. Pero bihira lumabas ang mga katutubo pag election. And it's really very difficult. That's my challenge to galvanize the IP vote based on an IP agenda.
Okay. Anything you'd like to add before we go? Where are you headed next?
I'm going to Palawan tomorrow to meet the indigenous people to join them sa IP summit nila. Again, as I've said, that's my focus right now, talking to tribal leaders. It's a challenge. Kaya nga, I will not be joining Lenny's sortie because it's my own sortie.
Okay.
They identify kasi with me because of my work in the House of Representatives. I'll be in my ethnic attire. I'll be talking about issues that are close to their heart. There is the environment and culture domain. I'm going to also do it in other regions, no? So Mindanao, even sa Visayas, kasi the most marginalized of IPs are actually the IPs in Visayas.
If you don't win, Teddy, what role would you like to take in government if Aleni Robredo makes it? If she wins, what position or what role would you like to take?
Well, if she offers and she asks me, you choose. Then something to do with natural resources management.
Like DENR? Like you want to be DENR secretary?
Like yes, the DENR or the Department of Agriculture. Because this is my expertise naman former governor and congressman. It's always been.
So what would you do about mining? I mean, now that you've mentioned it just very quickly, we saw how the late Gina Lopez's battle against mining turned out.
Yeah, yeah.
If you were DENR secretary.
I'll be the incarnation of Gina Lopez, IP style. Which is really about consensus building. There's a law that we've been pushing.
So you are not against mining or you are against mining?
I'm not saying that we should stop mining. Mining is still part of the economy, but I'm open to declaring no-go mining zones, whether it's prime agriculture lands or critical water sheds, bringing back the ban on open-pit mining. So, kumbaga, we have to explain that the Philippines is an archipelago and, you know, pag small islands ka and then you have mine in the midst of these small islands, grabe yung impact niya sa agriculture and tourism. So if I were to choose, I'd choose agriculture, tourism over mining. That's my personal position when it comes to developing the economy. But we still need minerals. And the thing is, even if we have all of these minerals, we ship them overseas. That's our mining industry. So sa akin, let's really have a new mining law, which na ang processing of the mineral ore is in the Philippines para hindi iba nakikinabang. And declaring areas na talaga as no-go mining zones. That's my position when it comes to mining.
All right. On that note, Teddy Bagilat, good luck to you, sir. And I guess, what's your number on the ballot?
Number four.
Oh, number four. Well, good luck to you, sir. I hope to speak with you
again. Thanks, Karen. Thank you very much.